Hey, Trendies, how's it going? Trendy May reporting in. It's 3:40 in the afternoon in NorCal on a Tuesday morning, Tuesday afternoon. Chilling with the guys in Stick Cam. And I received a message from somebody. And I thought it was interesting enough that I would share it with y'all and give you my response. So I'm just pulling up his letter right now. My inbox here. There we go. So looks like a younger guy. And the title of his message to me was, "You're awesome, Nay." I thought it was interesting. But the guy's name is The Redneck Show 88. And we'll get into what he said in a minute. I got a nice, clean roar. You know what that means? I'm going to put some Nays Ultra Jacket and make a stone. I'm going to make a stone fun nice times, eh? I'm going to make a interesting. Damn. Ultra Jack. Nays Ultra Jack. You guys hoping? I'm hoping that you guys are enjoying the longer videos. I'm going 24 minutes now on them, which seems to be working good for everybody. So it's hard to come up with stuff to talk about for 24 minutes. But then again, when I'm watching a video on YouTube, it doesn't matter who it's from. I'd much rather watch a longer video than a shorter video. I always check the times of videos before I watch them. And if I see a video, it's like 20 or 30 minutes, I'm all giddy about it. I'm like, oh, it's a long video. I'll be here for a while. That's cool. I'll be entertained for the next half hour, you know? So, yeah, man. I'll keep them up there to 24 minutes. It's working. Like I said, I'm gonna put a little some oil. Yes, you are in the video. Supposedly. Get my lighter on this and do it a little faster. Oh, perfect. Perfection. Okay, so I hope that all you guys have your bongs out, including Redneck Show 88. Hope you got your bong out too, bro. Gah. Y'all want to smoke along. Cyber? I don't know how much delay time I have with the guys, but I'm just going to type out cheers and hit it. Cheers, bro. And cheers to all the viewers out there. And in fact, if we wait 15 seconds, we can smoke right on the 420. On the 420, yo. Cheers, happy 420. Thank you. All right, let's start with the letter. You're awesome, Nate. Bro, I love your videos. I completely support the legalization of cannabis, but I am a Republican. Please do not take this the wrong way. I like to get all views on current political events, as they are important to the survival of this country. What I'm saying is, even though I may be a Republican, I'm not an ignorant Republican. I think the world should treat everyone as equals and live together in peace. But clearly, we both know this isn't going to happen, although it's a plausible idea, if not plausible, but I'd really rather not get bashed for my political views, just like you said in the current events bit about what Chick-fil-A is doing. It's very wrong, but at the same time, you talked about being in someone else's shoes. My shoes, for instance, I don't feel comfortable watching someone I've known to speak the truth bash everyone in one certain political party for the party's actions. As a whole, not everyone that is Republican is a narrow-minded, ignorant redneck. Now that is, I'm only speaking for myself, I have no idea about others, but thoroughly enjoy your videos, and I hope that this message finds you well, and also that I can still be a trendy or subscriber, regardless of my affiliations with, in quotes, those people. Peace. That's the letter. Excellent fucking letter. This is the kind of letter I would like to receive from somebody. You show me how much of a fucking man you got, how big your fucking balls are. Send me a fucking letter like that. Massive thank you to the Redneck Show 88. Dude, I'm saddened that there are trendies out there who choose to be Republicans. I'm saddened. Especially when you can see what your party does. I know if you would pay attention to everything they did, you probably, I'm going to say you would leave the party. Regardless, you've made your choice, and whether, you know, your parents were both Republicans and it's just in your family, whatever the reason, your reason is for being a Republican, and you choose to be a Republican and you choose to be trendy, that's a contradiction in terms. It really is a contradiction in terms. And it's interesting. It's something I'd like to spend more time thinking about and talking about, whatever. So, man, I appreciate your letter. And, yeah, you can stay trendy, man. If I'm out there cursing you out up and down for being a Republican in a video, and you come back and say, hey, man, is it still cool if I'm still a trendy? Yeah. Absolutely. It's awesome. And I appreciate the letter, man. I really do. So that's what this video was for. I just wanted to read your letter and tell you that I am taking it under consideration, what you said, everything you said, and I'll be thinking about it. I might be making more videos about it, but one thing's for sure is the Republican Party would have to make a lot of changes before I would accept them as a political equal. They've taken stands on things that shouldn't even be in politics. They've taken stands on things like religion. They've taken stands on abortion. You know, why do you, if you're in a political party, why do you have to take a stand on that? Why can't you just say, okay, well, abortion's whatever. Let's just leave that out of our party, and we'll do what we want, which is less government. We want to keep our guns. You know what Republicans are all for? Less spending. Less going out and helping the rest of the world. They want to keep all the money here because they're greedy. Sorry, redneck. So this video is not for the purpose of bashing the Republican Party. I think I've already done that beautifully in the previous video. But this is for redneck, and I'd love to talk to you at length about your, because it sounds like you're the kind of person who is reachable. When I was talking about black and white and talking to a wall, you know, I get to someone like you who is willing to talk. You're still saying you're a Republican, but you're willing to talk. So that definitely makes Republicans look a lot better. Let me close this window out. Okay, so let me see what's going on here. Erbrocker just said, I just took the rest of my weed to the dome. Booyah to the brain. Keep you informed of what's going on inside the room. Booyah! Now we're all going to start saying booyah. Who would be Nade's vice president? Cyber Reload. Of course. As if there would be some sort of... There would be some question. There's no... I wouldn't even hesitate, man. He's fucking Cyber Reload, man. He's my vice president. He's my VP. Something happens to me, you deal with him. He's in control. Dude, Snoop Dogg changed his name to Snoop Lion. Okay? I wanted to be... If you haven't heard that, I wanted to be the person to bring you that news. You heard it here first on Trendy Ass Dabbers channel on YouTube. Maybe I'll title it, Snoop Dogg Changes Name to Snoop Lion. That'll just be the title when it's actually was supposed to be a response to Redneck. Yeah, really, for real, Snoop Lion. He is now a reggae artist. He's not into rap anymore. He's kind of pushing rap aside, and he's like being a little firm about it. He's a reggae artist now. His name's Snoop Lion. Yeah, man, Snoop Lion, I like the ganja. But the thing about it is, I don't like reggae music. And I don't see a necessity to correlate oneself with a style of music because there's a certain kind of a medication that you like to take. I like, just because, it, like, for instance, let's say you like to drink beer. Does that mean you're a margaritas? Does that mean you're a big old fucking Jimmy Buffett fan? What if you hate Jimmy Buffett but love margaritas? That's where I'm at. I don't like reggae, but I love my ganja, man. So, Snoop Lion. I'm not smoking to that. I'm smoking to fucking the hardcore rap Snoop Dogg used to put out. Yeah. Cheers to that. There's only one reggae song I like in the whole world. It's the intro song to Cyber's videos.
Marijuana makes me feel so fine.
Every time I hear that, I'm like, oh, get ready to watch a Cyber video. Okay. Wow, we're just cruising right on through this video. Let's see, we've talked to Redneck about Republicans. We talked about Snoop Dogg changing his name to Snoop Lion. Give you a little bit of nay news, what I've done today. Went outside and I built a staircase out of stone. Got these big rocks, some of them weighed like over 100 pounds. And I fucking put them on this ledge going down where I like to walk all the time, but... It's really treacherous and steep and slippery. And I went ahead and filled it with some rock in between the stones and braced it and walked up and down it. It's a really nice little staircase I made. And I cleaned out this courtyard area and I built this border out of more of those stones. I carried all those stones along the back border and I made these little rings of rocks around the plants. And I trimmed the fucking trees. So when you walk by, you can see everything. It looks really pretty. It looks like a little park. Happy 420. Sorry, I missed that. And let's see. What else did I do? I watered all my plants and checked for spider mites and saw none after spraying the organicide yesterday. That was good to see. Because I'm expecting to see some more mites somewhere. And what I really want to do, what I'm thinking about doing, is just spraying rosemary every day. Fucking for the rest of my life. I'll never see another mite if I do that. That would be fucking great. because it kills every wave. As soon as the eggs hatch, boom, they fucking die before they get to lay more eggs. But it's man, out here right now, I'm doing so much shit, and I really just don't have the... Oh, a fucking hummingbird just fucking slammed into my window. I don't have the motivation to do spraying every day. It's really a task. It's quite a task to have to mix it up and then walk it around to all the plants and spray all the plants from top to bottom. But you know, if I want to be mitless, unfortunately, out here it might be the only solution. Because I don't want to use any kind of toxic chemical or anything like that in my plants, even during veg. And people do that. You know, they use this stuff called Avid, and it's systemic, which means it remains in the plant. So when the spider mite takes a bite out of the plant, he gets a fucking mouthful of the poison and he fucking dies. That's not medical marijuana. So it's just going to be a matter of trying to see what's our best way through this, you know, what's our highest level of control. Oh, God, yeah, those little fuckers, man, fuck you up, man, they will fuck you up. I remember the first time I got them, and it was a fucking nightmare. And then, for over a year and a half after that, not having rosemary oil, oh, my God, that was even more of a nightmare, because then I knew what they were, and I couldn't control them. I sat there and I struggled, and I finally fucking came up with something that made me happy on both all natural and something that actually killed those little fuckers. Our problem outside is those plants are so big now. They're so big. There's so many leaves, and you got to get fucking happy 710 on the 1710, and you got to get fucking underneath them. Let's smoke on that. Well, fuck. Wait. I don't want to smoke on the 710 until I have a dab of oil on this Ultra Jack, man. And then I'll be good to go. Here, bear with, man. Bear with. Okay? It's a Toth Toke, too. It's top of the hour. It's fucking 1710 in the video. Fucking milk this shit. Yo. Cheers. Here, let me say cheers, and I don't know how long my delay is, so cheers. Oh, no delay at all. That's beautiful. Someone sent me a message about my chair. They sent me a private message. They said, dude, I love your computer chair, because every time you take a hit, you do that layback thing where you really fucking appreciate the fact that your chair can really get back there and you can feel the full effects of that marijuana going through your extremities. And it really does. It's cool to be able to just kick back after you do a bong hit. I love that feeling. That was a great hit. I wonder how long that hit was. Anyway, thank you for watching my videos. I'm Trending A, and I'm trying to say that I am signing out today. That is me right there. Anyway, hit subscribe. Happy 420. Legalize everywhere. Peace! Hey, wait a minute. We got 4 more minutes, don't we? 4 pictures of Nay saying we got 4 more minutes. That's fucking awesome. I like to say that we got more time to play with Nay today. Biebs! Fuck yeah, dude. Because you know it's on when Biebs shows. Biebs is like, oh, I woke up from my nap, let's fucking get trendy. Let's fucking get trendy up in this bitch. He's laughing now. That delay is funny. It's funny when you say shit and then you gotta wait for people to hear it. Alright, let's go with blank image. Yeah, right on! Right on! Let me finish what was in the bowl. Really quick here. Just get rid of that smoke. And let's move on to some Afghan Kush. Yeah. I can't believe nobody fucking sent me a message about that. Nobody sent me a message about, yeah. Come on, people. It's one of y'all. So many people out there, man, and nobody knows what that is from fucking Quake 3. Come on. John Wayne Gacy clown.
Fucking A. I should do a review.
I like them double bubble dabs. Like to serve up some honey oil on top of my bowl sometimes. You take a little piece of metal, you shine it up nice, you put your flame on it and get it all nice and hot so you can drop your oil on it. They call that a T.I. dabber. We like them T.I. dabbers. They call that a dabber dab. We like to take them dabbers down. We like to show you an example of the dabbers. I aim to show you a dab. I'm gonna put a little dab on this bowl.
I like when he did the long grunts. He knew something was up. Uh-oh, something's up with the dude. God damn, this is a bowl I will not be able to finish in one breath, okay? I'm pretty sure. I wish you could have seen the thing go on there. It looked like someone was dropping caramel on an ice cream cone. Baby, I'm going to set this bitch on fire. And then I'm going to try to smoke the whole thing anyway. No promises, yo. Cheers. There's a 24-minute mark. All right, we'll stop at a 24:20. Per request of one of the trendies, he's like, stop at a 24:20. Happy 420. Hit subscribe. Legalize everywhere. Thanks for watching my videos. Peace!